Welcome back. At this point, many of us have burned through all of our favorite movies and TV shows. We know there is so much content out there, but it can be hard to sift through it all and choose something to commit endless hours to. But that's why we've called our friend, Kathleen Newman-Bremang, in, who's got her finger on the pulse of the best pop culture has to offer. Kathleen joins us from St. John's, Newfoundland now with the ultimate what to watch list and the ultimate tracksuit always. Hi, Kathleen.
Hi, thank you so much for all the compliments. Put on my fancy sweats for you.
I love it. We're going to start with a show that I am absolutely obsessed with, and I, like you, want everyone to get onto the show. It's called Never Have I Ever. What do you love about this show?
I am so glad you love it as much as I do, because if you know me at all, you know that I love teen TV, and I think this show is perfect for if you're like me, who loves teen TV, if you're a teen yourself, or you're a parent of teenagers, because it's so heartwarming and funny and just a great comedy, period. It stars Maitreyi Ramakrishnan, who is from Mississauga. She beat up 15,000 other people to star in this show that is loosely based on Mindy Kaling's life as a South Asian teen, daughter of immigrants, growing up in America, and it just does that so well, toes the line of comedy and a little bit of drama. It'll make you cry, it'll make you laugh. It's so good.
Talk about busting through all the stereotypes as well. I mean, you get an Asian character who wants to be an actor. You have a biracial black and white character who needs to come out. She's trying to figure out a way to come out to her family. It's just, they've really handled busting a lot of myths and stereotypes, and I think they've done an incredible job. The next one is a film I'm dying to see, The Photograph. Tell us about it.
Yeah, and you know what? It's also kind of like everything you just said, in that I love Never Have I Ever because it's busting down stereotypes without, being stereotypical, but also without there being trauma attached to the race of these characters. And so this movie is called The Photograph. I'm still going on date nights, I don't know about y'all. So it is a romantic drama, and my date nights are really just like going to the couch and renting a movie. So this is available to rent on wherever you rent your movies. And it is a black love story that, like I said, is not rooted in trauma. It is not the stereotypes that you usually see black characters engaged in movies and on television. It's directed by another Canadian, Stella McGee. It stars Issa Rae, my girl from Insecure, and Lakeith Stanfield, who, if you watched a movie in 2019, you know Lakeith Stanfield because he's in everything. And they just fall in love in this really beautiful, slow-burning drama that I think you're gonna like. And it's good for a date night.
We're very much on the same page in that we want to see diversity without the trauma. I like to see diverse characters go through this period of self-actualization or romance or love or just a slice of life. Like, I am
yes.
So ready for a movie like The Photograph. So thank you for that. A good one on the list. Now let's switch gears to The Last Dance. You love, love, love this documentary.
I am on a high of The Last Dance. And I can't even talk about it without like vibrating, because it's so good. If you were old enough in the 90s to remember the Chicago Bulls, the glory days of the Chicago Bulls, you're gonna love this documentary. If you don't even like sports, I promise you're gonna love it, because you know these people. You know Michael Jordan, you know Scottie Pippen, you know Dennis Rodman. These guys are celebrities, not just athletes. And all of them are in this doc. They're spilling the tea on those years, all of the rumors that you've heard about Michael Jordan and his gambling, about that time he punched Steve Kerr in the face, about him quitting basketball and going to baseball. All of those stories are in this doc. It's told in such an incredible way. And it's just nostalgia for the 90s that takes you back to a simpler time. And I can't get enough of it.
Definitely my favorite time. I'm a 90s girl. Okay, Defending Jacob, what's that about?
Okay, so this is a show on Apple TV Plus that I'm actually surprised hasn't gotten a bit more buzz, considering who's starring in it. It stars Chris Evans, Captain America himself, in a role unlike we've really seen him in, because it's a gritty drama. His wife is played by Michelle Dockery from Downton Abbey, and they play parents facing the unimaginable. Their 14-year-old son is accused of murdering one of his classmates. And so it's not a light watch, but they do a really good job of engulfing you in this world, and you just want to find out what this mystery is. I am not done this series yet, but I heard the ending is wild, and it's one of those shows where you're just sitting on the edge of your seat, throwing out theories at your TV, yelling, being like, I think this person did it. So it's a really good drama if you're looking for that.
I love your recommendations. We ran out of time, but that's okay, because we're just going to save the other ones for the next time we chat.
That's all right.
And you do this every week, Kathleen. You got to check out her picks in her weekly column for Refinery29 called What's Good. So good to see you, girl. Have a great day.